My name is Scott, and this is Windows 8 in 3 minutes. First half will be mice, second half will be keyboard. This is your start screen. This is what you get when you first log in. If you want to get back to your desktop, you can either click on desktop, or if you want to from the start screen, you can just throw the mouse into the lower left-hand corner of the screen. You see there's your desktop right there. Just throw the mouse in the corner and click. That's how you get back and forth to your start button. It's as if your start button is there, you just can't see it. Rather than being here, it's in the corner. You can move pretty fast. From here, I can start typing, and I can launch an application. That was a desktop application. If I open something like the browser, it goes full screen, and I can visit one of my favorite websites. I can then right-click. Right-clicking in any of these full-screen applications brings up additional information, like this menu bar. I can click, open up a new site, right-click, close a tab, see additional options. I want to get back to my start menu from here. I can just throw the mouse into the upper left-hand corner, like going backwards. This is your back button. I'm task switching through all of my different applications that I've been running. But I could also throw the mouse up into the upper left-hand corner and then just pull down. So upper left, pull down. Here's the applications that I've got running. Upper left, pull down. Lower left, click. There's my start. I can move forward and backward in my start just by moving the mouse up against the edge of the screen. But I can also scroll. I can use the keyboard. This is me using the arrow keys on the keyboard. Or I can use page up and page down. I can right-click on any one of these. Notice that they're moving. Those are called live tiles. I can turn them off if they're bothering me. I can also make them smaller, or I can move them around. Just right-click, and I can uninstall the ones that I don't want. If I run one of these applications, like, for example, Internet Explorer, I can then use the mouse, go up the top of the screen here, and you see that little hand. I can then pull it down. If I wanted to close this application, I just drag it down, throw it away. But I can run this application, grab the top, shove over to the side. You see me shoving over to one side or the other? I'm going to snap it there. I'll come back up to the upper left here, and I'll run another application. So here I've got weather, and I've got Google, but I want weather to be smaller. Now I've got Google over here. I can make this go away. Pick it up, drag it off to the side. Let's go back to my desktop. Run an existing desktop application. It's still Windows. You've got your Windows Explorer. I can drag files around. Everything else works exactly the same. If I don't like this ribbon, I can close that. I want to shut my application. If I want to shut my entire system down, I can just hit Alt F4. If I'm over in the Start menu and I want to shut my application down, just go to the lower right-hand corner and I can click on Settings, and the power is available right there. Using just the keyboard, I can hit Window D to go to the desktop. I can hit Window E to go to Explorer. I can hit Window R to run something. I can hit Window X to bring up this menu, which is for advanced users to do all sorts of stuff. I can hit Window F to go to Files and search for things. I can go hit Window W to search my control panel and ask questions of my system, like changing the resolution or maybe adjusting the brightness on my system. Hitting just the Window button and starting to type will automatically run applications. Hitting Window again will go back to the Start menu. So I've got Window E for Explorer, Window F for Find, Window to get to the Start menu. Window C brings up those little charms on the side there. That works in any application. So even if I'm looking at stocks, I can hit Window C, click on Settings. I was looking at a particular story and I hit Window C. I could click on Devices, and if I had a printer, I could print. If I have another screen, I could send it there. Or if I have a near-field communications device like a phone, I could even send that off to my phone. Window D to my desktop, Window to go here. I can do all of this stuff with the mouse or with the keyboard. Here I am moving around the keyboard, right-clicking with Shift F10. Totally accessible using the keyboard or the mouse. And again, I can always go back to my desktop, and it's still Windows. That's Windows 8 in 3 minutes.